Welcome to the Vue Diagram tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Vue Diagram component. Using the Diagram component, you can create and edit interactive diagrams like flowcharts, organizational charts, mind maps, BPMN charts, and UML diagrams. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a Vue project and add the Syncfusion Vue Diagram to it. I will explain how to create nodes, connectors between nodes, segments, and annotations for the connectors. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the vuejs command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js to follow along. To create a project in Vue, open Visual Studio Code, and in the terminal, type the command npm create vuejs. Provide the app name, select the Vue framework, and the variant is JavaScript. Navigate to the project folder and run the npm install command to install the required dependencies. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vue project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Diagram component, install the package using the command npm install @syncfusion_dj2vuediagrams save. This command installs the Vue Diagrams package along with its dependencies. You then need to register a trial license key to use Syncfusion components. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, register the trial license key. To see how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured with the license to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the diagram component, open the app view page and remove the default code. Then, add the script tag and import the diagram component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Diagrams package. Define the diagram component in the components collection with a tag name. This way, you can use this tag and create the diagram component within the template. Add a template tag, and within it, add the EJS diagram tag and set the ID for the component. Bind the width and height for the component. In the script tag, add the data function. Within it, return the width and height properties with values. I need to define the CSS for the diagram, so using the style tag, let me import the material theme. Save this application and run it using the command npm run dev. You can see the diagram canvas is rendered. Next, let's add a simple flowchart to the diagram that shows printing of the word Syncfusion 10 times. To do so, in the JS diagram tag, bind the nodes property with a variable. In the data function, define the variable. Within the script tag, define the nodes variable as an array of objects. Add an ID value to represent the node value uniquely. Add the height and width for the shape. The offset value for the x-axis, and the offset value for the y-axis. Set the annotations property with content start. This text will be displayed within the shape. These are all the basic properties for a node. Save the file. You can see the created node is rendered with defined x and y coordinates. Next, I will show you how to add a node with default height and width offset values. In the JS diagram tag, bind the getNodeDefaults property with a value. In the data function, define the getNodeDefaults property by passing a node parameter and set the node height, width, and offset for x and return the node parameter. Since I defined the default node values, in the node1 property, remove the height, width, and x coordinate values. The node renders with the default node values. Also notice here that by default, the shape type will be basic and the rectangle shape is displayed. If you want to change the shape and its type for the flowchart, then define a variable shape, set the type to flow and the shape to terminator. The flow shape is set to terminator to indicate that it represents the start point. Now you can see the diagram component displays the start point of the flowchart. The next step in this flowchart is to create a variable and initialize it. So we need to add a process shape to the diagram component. In the nodes collection, add a new node with an ID and offset Y. I do not set the offset X, height, or width since those will be set from the default node property. Set the shape property with the type flow and the shape process. This will draw a rectangle shape. Add annotations and set the content as create variable I equal to 0. In the diagram canvas, you can see the second node is a process shape with the defined content. Next, I will show you how to connect these two nodes using connectors. To use the connector property of the diagram component, in the JS diagram tag, bind the connector's property with a value. In the data function, define the connector's variable by setting a variable. In the script section, define the variable as an array of objects. Create a property named ID and provide a value. Add the source ID and assign the value node 1. Add the target ID and assign the value node 2. This will connect node 1 and node 2. You can see on the diagram canvas that the two nodes are joined by a connector. The next step of the flowchart is to add a condition that the initialized variable value should be greater than 10. To do this, I need to add a decision node in the flowchart. First, add one more node to the nodes collection. Add the properties ID and offset Y and set the shape property with the flow type and the decision shape. This will draw a diamond shape. Add annotations and set the content as is I less than 10. Define one more connector object in the connectors array. Add the properties ID, source ID, and target ID and set appropriate values to them. In the diagram component, you can see that the third node is rendered with the defined condition and the second and third nodes are connected. If the condition is satisfied, then I need to print the word Syncfusion and increment the I value with 1 in the flowchart. To do that, define two nodes in the nodes collection. Since I am printing the word Syncfusion here, the shape type is set as predefined process. In node 5, since I am showing the I value incrementation, the shape is assigned with the value process. To connect these nodes, in the connectors property, add new connector objects with source ID and target ID values. Now the diagram is displayed with two more nodes for printing the word Syncfusion and incrementing the I value. Also notice that the newly added nodes are connected using connectors. Next, we'll add the end node for this flowchart. So, add one more node in the nodes collection, set the properties ID and offset Y, and then set appropriate values to them. Since we're going to terminate the flowchart, assign the type to flow and shape to terminator. Next, use the annotations property to add the content. In the diagram canvas, the defined final node is added to the flowchart. Notice that in this flowchart, two flows are missing. One is when the I value is greater than 10, the execution should end. The other is after incrementing the I value. The word should continue to be printed until the I variable value is less than 10. To add these, first you need to add two more connectors using the connector property. Define the source ID and target ID properties. Connect node 3 with node 6 in order to connect the node from decision to end. For this connector, set the source ID and target ID values as node 5 and node 3 respectively to connect the increment node to the decision node. Looking at the diagram component, you can see the newly defined connectors from the incremental node and the decision node, which collide with existing nodes. To overcome this, we'll add additional segments to display those connectors clearly. To add segments, in connector 5, define a segments array property and define two segment objects with length and direction. One is for the right and another is for the bottom. This is because I need to add a segment flow from the right to bottom so it will connect to the end node. In the diagram canvas, now the connectors are displayed like this. To correct the flow, I need to set the connector type to orthogonal within this connector tag. In the diagram component, you can see that the flowchart ends when the variable I reaches the value 10. Do the same for connector 6, where the direction will be from left to top. In the diagram canvas, you can see the looping is performed until the I value reaches the value 10. Now let's add annotations to the connectors to make the flowchart clear. In connector 3, add the annotations property assign an array with an object with the property content. Set the value to yes. Add the style property with an object that contains a property named fill with the value white. This fill property will show the content without any background lines from the diagram canvas. In the diagram canvas, you can see the content yes in the connector that connects the decision and predefined process node. Do the same for connector 5, where I display the content no. You can see the complete flowchart, which prints the word Syncfusion 10 times. In this video, you saw how to create a diagram component in a Vue project. I showed you how to create and add nodes and define connectors and segments with annotations. If you would like to see a working example of this, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Vue suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.